Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you transmission medium in computer network. And I have seen students are thinking like this is just a theoretical topic. But let me tell you one thing. I have seen there are few questions that comes frequently in competitive examination based on this topic. So you should understand this topic thoroughly first, and I'll explain you few examples even based on this topic. That gives you more clarity regarding how exactly we can have transmission. So when it comes to transmission medium, there are basically two categories of transmission medium. One is guided transmission medium and second is unguided transmission medium. So let us see first how guided transmission medium is there. So when it comes to guided transmission medium, you should know it is also referred as wired communication link. Now first I'll explain you first category of guided transmission medium cable. So that is there as per twisted pair. First you need to see this diagram. You see we are having one cable over here, and inside this cable how many twisted pairs are there? You see this is one twisted pair, this is second twisted pair, this is third twisted pair, and this is fourth twisted pair. So with this given cable we are having in total four twisted pair, right? Now here in twisted pair what we do is we insert electrical signals, right? So with one twisted pair we can provide electrical signaling. Likewise here with this particular example we are having four twisted pair, right? Now let me tell you the brief history about this. Like this twisted pair cable that we were been using in early 1990s with telephone network. See, in 1990s telephone network was providing internet connection, right? In that, this type of cable that we were been using in that 1990s period. Right now probably you can observe we are using ethernet cable, optical cable, right, for internet connection. But in early 1990s internet was deployed along with telephone line where this type of cable was there, right? Now here see, it is a pair of two wires that you can say with twisted pair, and earlier telephone line was based on twisted pair only, where modem was used to connect with the server. Here we are passing electrical signals with this twisted pair, and you can say it is having very less range, and that range is there in terms of a few meters only, up to 100 meter only we can pass the signals. It is cheap. The reason is it is thin in terms of material and it is easily breakable. We can say this twisted pair that is also there inside ethernet cable. And you see here few examples are given for ethernet cable, and I have seen some questions are frequently coming based on what type of ethernet cable that is given based on some notation. So here if I say 10 base T that cable is given to you, then what is the meaning of this? See, this 10 means 10 Mbps speed is there with this given cable, and base T means here with this given table cable we are having one twisted pair. So 10 base T means 10 Mbps speed is there with the cable, and T means only one twisted pair is there. So with this cable we are having four twisted pair, but with 10 base T cable you will be having one twisted pair and speed will be 10 Mbps. When it comes to 100 base T type of twisted pair cable, in that case you can say speed is 100 Mbps, and base T means what? T indicates there will be one twisted pair inside given cable. When it comes to 10 base TX, what it means? Speed is 10 Mbps, and TX means there will be two pair of twisted pair cable, right? So inside cable there will be two pair of twisted pair. So here one and two, that is how two pair will be there. Here in total four pairs are there, right? So as if you wanted to know like what should be the notation for four twisted pair cable, so for that I can say 10 base T4 that will be written. So 10 base T4 means what? 10 will be the 10 Mbps will be the speed, and T4 indicates there will be four twisted pair. So based on notation you should know what kind of cable is given to you. So this type of questions that may come in competitive examination, right? It is quite easy. I think you can easily understand that based on these examples. Now let me explain you second type of guided transmission medium, where you see shielded twisted pair that we have. So here we are providing shielding of copper with twisted pair. You see here we are having four twisted pair, but all the twisted pairs are provided with aluminium foil shielding, right? So you see entire cable is getting shielded over here, and here aluminium foil shielding is happening. So this and this cable both are similar, only difference is shielding is there. Now what will happen because of shielding? See, one thing that will happen is, like you can say, this cable that will be stronger than this cable, that you can directly say. And secondly, because of shielding of aluminium foil over here, there will be less interference of signal in between these two cable, right? Like in single cable, there are how many twisted pair? You see four twisted pairs are there. So if you provide aluminium foil shielding over here, then noise will reduce in between these cables which are there in these twisted pairs which are there inside this cable, right? So that is the basic logic behind this. Like by providing aluminium foil shielding, we are reducing noise as well as we are increasing the strain. So you see here we are having two pairs of wires. Only thing is, we are providing aluminium shield over here. So individual shielding is happening as well as total wire shielding, that is also done over here. So it is increasing strain and it is reducing noise inside propagation of signal. And because of reduction in noise, range will increase. So range of this shielded pair with twisted pair, you can say it will be a bit more compared to this. So you can say it is sturdier than the normal twisted pair. Why? The reason is, here we are providing aluminium shield, right? Now let us try to understand how third guided transmission medium cable is there, like coaxial cable. And I think you might have seen that in your television connection, right? So for television connection, we use this coaxial cable. If you open up this coaxial cable, it will be looking like this, where this is inner conductor and outer conductor is separated by dielectric material, and this is a cover of that entire cable, right? Here what will happen is, you see signal that will be passed on with respect to these two wires only, right? And I have seen students are thinking like, here also we will be sending electrical signals only, right? So you can say it could be electrical signal, but not exactly the electrical signal which will be available over here, right? Here signaling will be very different with this coaxial cable. When we talk about coaxial cable, you should know even this coaxial cable that we use it in television connection, means with our TV we are having this, as well as with some broadband services we are having this type of cable. And right now also, with large scale, this coaxial cable that has been used, right? In 2023, this coaxial cable that has been implemented in many computer network. Now let me tell you some basics about this. Like you see, it is widely used in television, of cable television, and in broadband connection that we use, right? It offers low noise compared to this twisted pair. That's why its range is more. It is there in terms of 1 kilometer, right? And cost and strength of this coaxial cable, that is bit more compared to twisted pair cable. Now I have seen some questions are coming based on notation of cable, like as if it is given 10 base 2 kind of cable is given to you, then you should know this cable category that comes under the category of coaxial cable first. 10 base 2 means what? 10 is a speed in terms of Mbps, and base 2 means what? 2 into 100 meter distance, means 200 meter distance that is being supported by this given cable. So for 200 meter distance we can use that cable, right? 100 base 5 means what? 100 is Mbps speed which is there with given cable, and base 5 means 5 into 100 means 500 meter distance communication that is possible by this cable, right? You see here with twisted pair, it will be given in terms of 10 base T. So here T indicates how many pairs are there, while with coaxial cable, it will be given in terms of this, like 10 base 2. So here 2 gives you the distance of communication with this given cable, 2 into 100, right? Like sometimes they may give you like this, 100 base 6. So So 100 is Mbps speed, and 6 means 6 into 100 means 600 meter distance that will be there with that cable, right? Now I'm going to explain you third category of cable, that is optical fiber, right? So in this, you see we are having optical fiber cable where signaling will happen in terms of light signal, and for wideband application we use optical fiber, that you should, right? Right now current internet connection with computer network, that is having majority of base with this optical fiber connection only, right? If you see the basics, then you should know it is working based on light signal. It is having very low noise interference compared to all these cables. That's why it offers very high bandwidth, as well as we can use this cable for long distance. Why? The reason is it is having very low noise interference inside. And in single cable, you can observe how many fibers are there. You see, with this coaxial cable, we can have signaling with one line only, right? But over here with this optical fiber, you see how many fibers are there inside. So that many fibers can have individual separate bandwidth, right? So in short, you can say with single fiber cable, we can have many microfibers inside, and that leads to huge bandwidth. Each fiber inside single link will be having bandwidth in terms of 100 Mbps. So as if you have 10 fibers inside single cable, then you can say 100 into 10 means you can have 1 Gbps speed, right? So it offers very high bandwidth. That's why in majority of computer network, you will be observing optical fibers are connected, right? You can say it is costlier earlier, but because of some advanced fabrication technology, nowadays in 2023, cost of this optical fiber, that is going down. Now here also one example is given, like if cable is given as per this 1000 base FX, what it means, 1000 is a speed, means 1000 Mbps speed is there with given cable, and FX is optical fiber extension. And with this FX notation, you can say distance of communication will be 2 kilometer approximately. So this cable that could be used up to 2 kilometers, right? Likewise, as if it is given like 100 base FX, then you can say 100 will be 100 Mbps will be the speed, and FX explains you optical fiber cable is there, and with FX standard notation is there as per 2 kilometer distance, right? So that is how notations are there with different cables. So you should know about this basics of notation with cables, right? Now I'm going to explain you second category, that is unguided medium. So in unguided medium, we can say it is wireless communication link, and in that there are two categories only. One is infrared and second is radio wave. In infrared, you'll be observing we use that for short range communication, and many applications that you might have seen like TV remote control or AC remote control. So in that we will be using this infrared medium, right? It cannot penetrate through wall, right? So that is the biggest disadvantage of this infrared communication link. And you will be observing in earlier mobiles of Nokia in 2010s, we were been having low bandwidth data transfer as per infrared wireless link. So I was been using Nokia's N73 mobile, in that infrared data transfer technology was there, right? But because of there are many disadvantages with this technology, majority of applications were not utilizing this. Right now infrared communication, that is there with the application which is there based on remote control only, right? So in computer network, you will be observing usually we use radio waves, and this radio waves that we use it with Wi-Fi, that we use it with cellular tower, as well as with your mobile phone hotspot, we can use radio wave, right? Here you can observe with cellular tower, it offers long range communication, right? In terms of few kilometers, you can have a communication with cellular tower, right? As well as nowadays, there are some mobiles fabricated by Motorola company, by which satellite communication is also happening, right? So So for long range communication, we use radio wave. There will be high bandwidth that you can say in terms of wireless communication, like with your 5G network, you can have extremely high bandwidth available with your mobile, right? That is possible because of radio wave. So this is all about unguided medium and guided medium, which is there in terms of transmission medium with computer network. So by these mediums only, entire communication is happening inside computer network. I hope you have understood each and every point which I have explained over here. And what I want is you just write down some comments to give me motivation to make new courses for you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video.